Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and is a more specialized subject. Sikh is a way of life. It's not a tribe or qaum. My qaum is Jat, but I'm a Sikh. So here is exposition of John 8, verse 31 onward. Truth will set you free. So Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, if you abide in my word, you are truly my laborers and not the blind disciples as of the rabbis. And you will know the truth, gospel truth, you know, and the truth will set you free. And gospel truth will set you free, you know. It will clear all your doubts in your mind. They answered him, we are offspring of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. Though so far, you know, they remain faithful to Abraham, they are supposed to be free men and not to be enslaved by anyone. But when Jesus came, Roman was ruling the country because the Jew, they have become unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh when they became Jew outwardly. How is it that you say you will become free? So you said, you know, everybody is free, you know. How can you say that you are free? Is your freedom different from what the secular is? Jesus answered them, truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. So sins are, you know, transgression against the moral laws. But if you reject the moral laws and you see that your own heart had the copy of the moral laws, then you have nothing to fear. So truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not remain in the house forever. Here I give you the example. As Ishmael and Hagar were put out of the boundary of the promised land, the son remains forever. That means the son, you know, he represents the father and he occupies the house of the father. Father Abraham and Isaac stayed in the promised land and enjoyed the fruits of the Garden of Eden. So if the son, the Christ in you, sets you free, you will be free indeed. So Jesus set you free in spirit. And the Father Abraham and Isaac stayed in the promised land and enjoyed the fruits of Garden of Eden. So if the Son, the Christ, set in you, sets you free, you will be free indeed. Free again. Sorry. Then you are free, you know. I was speaking my own language. I know that you are offspring of Abraham, yet you seek to kill me because my word finds no place in you. which is very important. When you are speaking gospel, then gospel has no place in the hypocrisy of the people, as the dog collar people are, you know, in the churches. They are hypocrites. They are not working for God, working for money. So when the gospel is preached, then it exposes them. I speak of what I have seen with my father inside me. So father is inside us, you know. It's called Emmanuel. God is with us. And you do what you have heard from your secular father. So other people, you know, they people written in the book, you know, somebody write it, the other people carry on without understanding. So John the Baptist said that I am baptizing in water, and the one coming after me, Christ, he will baptize you in Holy Spirit. So everybody reads it, but very few understand what it means. So that's where the Christ comes in, that he will define everything. So who are of your father, the devil? You are. So Jesus proclaimed them that their fathers are devil, Jewish father. They answered from him, Abraham is our father. John the Baptist said, you know, when he was baptizing. So, don't you say you have Abraham as your forefather? I can turn stones, simple stones, which stand for simple-minded people, into the Jew, into the sons of Abraham. I can make them as the sons of Abraham, simple-minded people, but the clever people, you know, they are too clever. So, you are of your father, the devil. They answered him, Abraham is our father. John the Baptist said, don't you say you have Abraham as your forefather? I can turn stones. Stones stand for simple, thick-headed people, such as the Samaritans. Simple-minded people into the sons of Abraham through baptism in water. Instead, he called from the simple-minded people into the sons of Abraham through baptism. Instead, he called them brood of vipers, because they were uttering falsehoods, as these Shia, Sunni and other people are doing today. Jesus said to them, if you are Abraham's children, you would be doing the works of Abraham, or doing the works Abraham did of righteousness and not of fleecing the Gentiles by making them Jews through circumcision. Remember that these temple priests, you know, wanted to increase their congregation. So they just went around circumcising people. They're making them the sons of Abraham, because circumcision is a tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed. So, but now you seek to kill me. He says, you know, if you are sons of Abraham, then you should have the qualities of Abraham too, you know, not what you are telling me, lie and all that. So, if you were Abraham's children, you would be doing the works Abraham did of righteousness and not of fleecing the Gentile by making them Jews through circumcision. So these people, you know, the Jewish people in the temple, rabbis, clever one, they were putting on shawl and other thing, you know, which tempted the simple-minded person. Hey, let me also have this such a shawl. So then these people, you know, rabbis, they will go to such prune people, and then they will bring them to the temple, and through circumcision they will make them Jew outwardly. So this, through circumcision, the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth. He's preaching you the truth and you want to kill him. That I heard from God, or the knowledge of Oral Torah. So he was preaching it, you know, Oral Torah. And so they wanted to kill him. Oral Torah is nothing else but his word. Because his word cannot be written down in ink on paper. This is not what Abraham did. You are doing the works your father, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, as the faithful to Abraham and Yahweh as the 11 crook brothers of brothers of Joseph, you know. Joseph went to Egypt. Joseph sold him to Egyptians, did. When Joseph left the promised land for Egypt, none of the 11 left behind were truthful or righteous, but so, wherever is of God, hears the words of God. The reason why you do not hear them is that you are not of God. So people of God, they hear his word, whereas people who are not of God, they don't. That is what happened when Jesus was resurrected. Only those who believed in Jesus, they could see him. And who were, so they suffered. Here I so the reason why you do not hear them is that you are not of God as today. You can see the destruction caused by Mammon and Media, controlled by the Jews. Such devils, the tares, are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning expected in 2018. So up to that time, nobody can shake Israel. In reality, In reality, the chosen people are a nation of priests, and they should be leading the world to peace. But they are being blind themselves, so nothing could stop them, you know.